Today I am going to teach you ruling the countryside, lesson number 3 of class 8th. On 12 August 1765, the Mughal Emperor appointed the East India Company as the Diwan of Bengal. The actual event most probably took place in Robert Clive's tent with a few Englishmen and Indians as witness. But in the painting, which is on the page number 26 of your text book, the event is shown as a majestic occasion taking place in a grand setting. The painter was commissioned by Clive to record the memorable event in Clive's life. The grant of Diwani clearly was one such event in British imagination. As Diwan, the company became the chief financial administrator of the territory under its control. Now it had to be. Think of administering the land and organizing its revenue resources. This had to be done in a way that could yield enough revenue to meet the growing expenses of the company. A trading company had also to ensure that it could buy the products it needed and sell what it wanted. Over the years, the company also learned that it had to move with some caution. Being an alien power, it needed to pacify those who in the past had ruled the countryside and enjoyed authority and prestige. Those who had held local power had to be controlled, but they could not be entirely eliminated. How was this to be done? In this chapter, we will see how the company came to colonize the countryside, organize the revenue resources, redefine the rights of people, and produce the crops it wanted. Now, I am going to explain you these two paragraphs which I read here in a brief manner. The company becomes the Diwan. The East India Company was appointed as the Diwan of Bengal on 12th August 1765 by the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II. The company became the chief financial administrator of the territory of Bengal. The company could now administer the land and revenue resources of Bengal. The revenue from Bengal could be utilized to meet the growing expenses of the company. Over the years, the company officials understood the importance of those who had ruled the countryside in the past and had enjoyed authority and prestige. Those who had held local power had to be controlled, but they could not be entirely eliminated.